Disgusting. That's how AHL President Jack Butterfield termed last night's pregame brawl between Rochester and Hershey here at the Odd. 9 players were tossed out, and today fines and penalties were levied. Andy Risto, who suffered a concussion in the melee.
Danny in front. Here's a pass. A drive by Carter that went wide. Parker Hall, he leveled Bourque. Well, sure enough, watch Parker right here. Does he nail Bourque? He goes, and on top of that, he just drives him to the ice. Now Bourque, knocked over the blade of his stick. Here's Parker. He puts Bourque into the boards. Here's a pass now to Holt.
Here's the hit right here. Jeff Parker will go flying into Raymond Bourque. What a collision. Bourque has taken about 8 or 10 good hits every game. Buffalo hit him an awful lot so far in this series. I have a better look at it. Right from ice level. Here's the collision.
Trying to come up with it, gets it back in now to O'Neill in front. Oh, and Rob Bray tried to get the backhand of the net, but he had to let it go quickly.
Oh, Parker
just
hit Bourque.
Bourque down.
The hit right here by Jeff Parker, and he really nails Bourque and just buries him with a check.
Brad Miller is not in the lineup, although he was in the warm-up. He was called up from Rochester, and we're talking 5.
Oh, did he ever get killed?
Got Gillis at center ice. Here they go again, folks.
Oh, did Gillis ever...
Kimball and Parker.
Oh, he caught him with a long one. Here they go. Toe to toe. Oh, what haymakers they were throwing. Big Jeff Parker just took Gillis and broke him in half, went over and dropped the toughest guy in the ice probably for Quebec with just big looping right.
And
opened him up, too. Opened them up. You want to play with the bull, you get the horn. And there's Michel Bergeron, the guy that set the whole thing off last night.
So Kimball gets his after last night when he went in and he just leveled Rick by from behind with a shot to the helmet. There's Kimball and Parker. They're just screaming.
Jeff knows he got him. He knows he got him. Big looping rights that he ever gets what Dandy did. I didn't think he could throw him that good. Did he ever catch him? Here's that big hit right here. Down goes Gillis. Like a ton of bricks. Watch Gillis right here. He's going to try to find out what country he's in. Well, look at him. Look at him. He can hardly stand up. He doesn't know if he's alive right now. You're in Buffalo, by the way.
Yeah.
Up to McGuire at center. He'll bring it back into the Hartford zone. McGuire. Now it comes to the side of the net. Recovered by Francis. Hartford goes after him. They put Cunnyworth down to the ice. Really leveled Cunnyworth with a hard hit right here. You see Parker came in. It was a clean hit. He stood right up and whacked him down to the ice. And after that, Cunnyworth came back, loaded for bear. With a Priestley with it again. Now Priestley, and he's all down. There's going to be another penalty to the Bruins.
They can't try on that call. Talbot is...
Here's Parker, and away he goes with Sweeney.
That's not going to help. Forget about the power play, but Parker's going to go. They'll nullify the 2 minutes. Oh, man. I'll tell you, they had an opportunity of a lifetime right there. Thalvin was called. The penalty was on Thalvin and Lake Parker. He'll pick up to himself. That evens everything up. But there's the hit by Sweeney. No big deal. Parker comes right back, catches him in the side of the mouth, buries him with a right. That doesn't help right now.
Behind 4-0 with Boston Garden fans gleeful at the sight. The Buffalo Sabres fought back with a vengeance yesterday against the Bruins. Jeff Parker closed the gap to 5-4 early in the third.
Shepard now ahead to Parker into the Boston zone. Parker goes to the corner, turns. Here's a pass in front. They score! Parker spun around from the far board and then Bourque just walked it off the blade of his goal stick. And the Sabres have tied it at 2.
Almost the same type of goal that Boston scored. Long shot, the goaltender should have had it, just like Darren Pooper should have had the goal by Boston.
He was probably worried about Shepard going in front of the Boston net.
Either that or he screened him a bit on it.
Now it's intercepted. They keep it in. Here's Hartman trying to get to it. Blows puck, they score! Parker! Jeff Parker!
Parker went after that bouncing puck in front of him, and the Sabres have taken a 3-1 lead.
Gosselin looked very tentative on this goal. And once again, Raymond Bourque popping the puck up in the bad position. That's twice this game. Now, watch Parker. He just jumps in there, has all the working room in the world. And terrific pressure right here by the Sabres. They're really dominating right now as far as forechecking is concerned.
Here's the announcement of the goal.
Assist number 20, Mike Hartman, and number 19, Kevin McGuire. Parker from Hartman and McGuire. The time, 15:41.